from Financial Peace Plaza, it's the Dave Ramsey Show, where debt is dumb, cash is king, and the paid-off home mortgage has taken the place of the BMW as the status symbol of choice. I'm Dave Ramsey, your host. You jump on. We'll talk about your life and your money. It's a free call. And some say the advice is worth what you pay for it. The phone number is 888-825-5225. 888-825-5225. You can also go online at DaveRamsey.com. Click on Dave's email. Please keep those brief and to the point, and we'll do our best to answer them as a part of the show today. So, thanks for joining us. We appreciate you being here. Rusty is in Los Angeles to start this hour off. Hey, Rusty, welcome to the Dave Ramsey Show.
Hey, thanks for taking my call, Dave. I was wanting to know, my company's offering me their company stock at 10% off, and I spoke with the superintendent, owner, whatever, of the company, and he's telling me I can take as much of the company as I want, as much of the company stock, at that 10% off, and I can sell it as soon as I want, including the same day that I bought it. Is there any reason why I should make 10% of my money and just buy and sell within 20 minutes?
You need to check on the fees it'll take you to sell it and what fees they employ to buy it. As long as the stock isn't really volatile and it doesn't go down 12% in 20 minutes, I guess you'd be okay, right?
That's what I was taught. I just didn't know if
it could go down. It could go down in 20 minutes. I mean, it really could. And so, number one, I wouldn't borrow any money to do this.
Right.
Number two, if you're going to buy it, do have it set up with a broker already, a low fee situation to turn around and liquidate it literally in 20 minutes. Don't hold it. Don't buy it to hold.
Okay.
And here's why I wouldn't buy it to hold. If you were to pull your company up on a stock chart, which would be very easy to do at many, many different websites, you could look at what's called your 52-week high and your 52-week low. Meaning the best price it sold at and the worst price it sold at in the last year.
Mm-hmm.
And you will see a variance of more than 10% between those two figures.
Right.
And so if you buy it and hold it a year, there's a good chance you could lose. So I don't play single stocks for that reason. I love the stock market as a concept, and thereby I invest through good mutual funds because I'm in a bunch of different companies. The money's spread out, and I'm not going to take it on the chin if one company goes down.
Okay.
And so, but if you want to mess with this a little bit, I certainly wouldn't bet everything you have on it or something like that. But if you want to try it once and say, all right, I'm going to buy this and resell it in 20 minutes and see what I make on, you know, drop a couple $1,000 into it or something like that, see how that works, that'd be fine.
Well, that's what the employees have been doing. I talked to 500 employees and they said that their return on investment is 8.5%.
Yeah, they probably got a discount brokerage firm of some kind that is just, you know, doing the stock turn for them. But again, don't get enamored with this or get sucked into this and have too much of your world tied up in case something goes bad. Number two, do it in cash. And then number three, whatever you do, don't change your mind and decide to be a person who keeps the stock.
Right.
But yeah, I think if you can flip it immediately and you want to play with that a little bit, I've not got any problem with you playing with it under that idea. The thing you got to remember, Rusty, is don't try to find one thing that is somehow the one thing that if I just take this pill I'll be rich then, and don't take if I take this pill I can lose weight. You know, it's just not one thing. It's an overall view of life that causes you to become wealthy, and that's what you're trying to keep in your mind. So if you want to mess with this a little bit, that's fine. But don't make it the one thing that you're trying to do to get rich with or something. Jason is in Tulsa, Oklahoma. Hi, Jason. How are you?
Hi, Dave. Thanks for taking my call.
Sure. How can I help?
I am currently holding three jobs right now to try to work through your debt snowball.
Wow.
My wife is a stay-at-home mom with three kids.
Wow.
And currently I have a full-time job where I work about anywhere from 45 to 50 hours a week. I preach on an interim basis at a church and deliver pizzas two nights a week.
Wow.
The question I have, we just started the debt snowball basically when we got our tax return. In the last 5 months, we paid off roughly $5,000. My total income With it all is probably about $50,000 a year, roughly.
What do you make at your main job?
My main job is about 36, and 36, 38, somewhere in there. Delivering pizzas is just, you know, a little bit, maybe about $4,000 a year, and then I make about $12,000 at the church.
Okay.
My question is, the church is actually going to be going through a merger in which I will no longer be a part of it. It's a good thing for the church. It's just, you know, the direction they need to go. With that being said, they're going to be giving me a generous severance for about 6 months. About $6,000 is what I've been told.
That's very kind.
That is very kind of them, very unexpected. The question I have, we are still about $10,000 in debt. Roughly $10,000 to $11,000 in debt, and I'm getting burned out. The question I have is: do I look for another third job and kind of keep that as a severance? If we don't have that income, we'll be negative cash flow for about $600 a month.
Not if you pay off the debt.
That is the other question.
No, it's extra income, and I think you stay on your debt snowball, and you attack the debt snowball with the money that comes in, and you just kick your number of hours up delivering pizza to offset your preaching. I mean, I know people making $1,500 to $2,000 a month delivering pizza at night.
Right. See, that's part of the question is, you know, do I take part of that or take that six, pay off part of the ten, and that makes it, when we did our budget this weekend, that makes it to where we basically break even for the month.
Yeah.
You know.
That's with the pizza money or without the pizza money?
With adding at least one extra shift on the pizza money. Part of the problem, to be completely honest with you, is I get off my primary job a little bit too late to go do a secondary pizza job. And so, unless it's on the weekends.
You pick up your weekend and go there. And that's temporary until you get the rest of the debt paid off, and until you know you need to be thinking long term career what you're going to be doing. That's not $36,000 a year too.
Mm-hmm.
So
right.
Where are you going to be in 5 years? So that you're not delivering pizza.
Right. Exactly. Okay.
And the other thing, the third thing is this: what denomination were you preaching in?
It's a non-denominational church.
Perfect. Perfect. Right. So you're set up to where you could do this again for someone else,
right?
And you have, exactly. Start putting out some feelers, and because there's a lot of people need pulpit fill,
right?
Backfill, and even evangelism and some of those kinds of things. There's a lot of places that you can go to use that skill and, you know, your calling from the Lord to serve people and make a legitimate, fair income in the process. That, you know, by far defeats pizza. So, on a whole bunch of fronts. So, I think I'm looking for that. I'm going to use the $6,000 on the debt snowball and pick up the pizza and pick up the preaching both until we can get wrapped up and get the career transitioned completely. Hope that helps you. This is the Dave Ramsey Show.